Hello, I'm Isaki Yamahata. In this session, I'd like to discuss about container support for SGX environment. This session is made with great help of my colleague, Dimitri and Anyo. So I'd like to thank them here. Recently, confidential computing is getting momentum so that Linux Foundation founded Confidential Computing Consortium. People use cloud service with Kubernetes, so only providing basic trusted execution environment is not enough, but also integration with Kubernetes or any other popular container management system is quite important for wide acceptance. At first, I'd like to discuss about what confidential computing or trusted execution environment is, and then discuss about taxonomy of container support. And then at last, as concrete example, I'll discuss about Graphene DBOS shielded container. These days, cloud computing is widely accepted. Usually data is encrypted in transfer over a network, but when processing data in CPU, it's not encrypted. On the other hand, usually machine is managed by cloud service provider. And also on the same machine, workloads by someone else may run in the same machine. So data can be stolen. For example, hypervisor or host OS can snoop your data by, and hypervisor and host OS is managed by cloud service provider. Or someone else running workload on the same machine can attack your workload. So there is a gap to protect data while processing. So the new way of computing is called confidential computing. It protects data confidentiality, integrity, and replay protection for computations by encrypting the main memory and shielding access to the data. So that's a way to fill the gap for protection, data protection. It requires trusted execution environments or TE as a basic building block to isolate the execution environment. TEE is typically implemented as a software. Software as hardware. And in this figure, it means CPU box. The hardware is trusted to isolate the TEE from other software, other applications, host OS or hypervisor or even firmware. It protects by denying any access from non-TE execution by hardware. Also, the CPU attests the state of TEE to a third party so that external verifier to provision secrets to the TEE. So when you provision secrets to the TEE, you'd like to confirm that the program running inside the TEE is really yours, not compromised. So attestation is quite important, is also important, not only in addition to protecting memory itself. In the cloud environment, TEE is the only building block in cloud ecosystem. Users typically uses Kubernetes to run their workload. There is a high bar for adaptation of TEE or confidential computing. So we'd like to lower the bar for it. It means user should be easily able to reuse the existing container image and then user protect their data. As users deploy their workload via container management system like Kubernetes, user can convert their container image to enable TEE. It means conversion from normal container image to TEE enabled image. Then the user can enable TEE, can run TEE protected workload on the converted image. So there are two dimensions to enable TEE of container image. One is the scope of protection. Another one is how to run TEE or program in within TEE. The container workload can be composed of multiple programs. There are main workload and helper programs typically. One option is to protect all programs running inside the container. Another option is to protect only main workload, which processes secrets. Another dimension is how to run TEE. One way is no specific way. There's no special way for user to specify, or because all the programs are run in TEE. Well, another way is to specify programs to be run in TEE. Typically, programs to be run in container is specified by a Docker file or a command. And then it can be converted by wrapper to TEE wrapper so that programs can be run in TEE. And typically to run TEE programs in TEE, some preparation is needed. Because for attestation or some configuration needs to be passed to TEE wrapper. For container support, there are several levels to enable TEE in container environment. The right one is the manual way and the left one is the most automatic way. The right one is to do all in manual way. If you are early adapter and want to fully optimize it, you can do it in full manual ways. You can install TEE software in container image and update to invoke programs with TEE. But it's a high cost and you have to know everything about what you are doing. The next way is automatically convert container image and also automatically update your scripts. Typically, in Dockerfile, entry point specifies which programs to run. So converter can analyze which entry point, can find out entry point. And then convert commands to from normal commands invocation to wrap TEE wrapper. But in this case, manual execution won't be supported. If user types a Docker exec bash, it won't be protected. The third one is to integrate container runtime with TEE so that every invocation of workload in a container will be done via dedicated container runtime so that all programs will be run under TEE. In this case, Docker exec will be covered too. The last one is to use Kata container and protect VM as a whole. In this case, a whole container is protected and this model protected, but this model won't be discussed in this section. I included it here for completeness of this matrix. However, integration with containers runtime takes a long time and it requires a big effort. So for near term, we enabled a short auto image conversion as a short term for easy adaptation. After this is achieved, we can attack Kubernetes integration as a long term. So as next, let's move on to concrete example of Graphene SGX and Graphene Shielded Containers support. SGX stands for Software Guard Extension, and it is one of the TEE implementation. SGX Enclave is a special memory region in process user process, and which is encrypted. On DRAM and memory bus, only encrypted data is used. And kernel or VMM or even firmware cannot see enclave memory. When booting enclave in user space, memory is measured so that its startup state is known and integrity is guaranteed. Further, to help enclave security, execution in enclave is restricted. For example, syscall instruction is not allowed to execute. So, for our goal, if we simply put in application binary a modified way into SGX enclave, it doesn't work as expected because, for example, syscall instruction is not allowed. So, simply it won't work. So, typically, application needs to be modified at source code level, and it will split application into two components. One part is component running within SGX enclave, which is protected, or it can be considered as trusted. And the other part runs outside SGX enclave, and which is untrusted. But for automatic container image conversion, this is not desirable. So something needs to be done. So here, Graphene RiboS comes into it. The answer, the way to run unmodified binary inside enclave, library OS hooks the system call from the application within enclave. And it tries to emulate Linux system call API. And then if really necessary, for example, for IO, file IO or network IO and so on, so on. It really needs to request to host kernel. So it goes out of enclave and then untrusted code is executed, and then final system call, host system call is sent to host OS. Let me introduce Graphene Library OS. Graphene LibOS is an open source project and hosted in GitHub, and it's actively developed in the community, and it supports SGX, and it loads applications, unmodified applications into SGX enclave and Flux Linux system. And PAL stands for platform abstraction layer. And PAL is actually split into two, and trusted PAL, which runs inside SGX enclave, and untrusted PAL, which runs outside of SGX enclave, which means it is untrusted. Next, let me introduce Graphene Shield Red Git containers integration. For automatic conversion, Graphene Shield Red container is developed in the community, and it's already merged in the repository and already available in the release at the point of release version 1.1. It takes normal Docker image and also optional manifest file or other configuration files. And then GSC built Graphenizer Docker image. It installs Graphene runtime in the image and also builds some configuration file, which is called manifest for each application. And then the developer signs its image And then after that, we can use Docker run command. Our application will be run inside SGX enclave. This slide depicts how GSC converts Docker image. One is a first step is it installs Graphene runtime in the image. And then it generates a configuration file for each application. And then it analyzes Docker file and to find entry point. Container entry point and the CMD entry point so that it converts a command executable to run application inside SGX instead of plainly running application. And also, it tries to access the file system as a mount point. And also, it needs to calculate dependency. Because usually applications are links to many shared libraries. So Graphene DBOS also needs to load shared library into the enclave. Okay, summary. Confidential computing and trusted execution environment are key components to protect secrets in cloud environment. And SGX and Graphene DBOS are basic building blocks for TEE to enable unmodified binary. And the Graphene Shielded Container or GSC allows users to automatically convert container image for TEE enabled image. So that user can easily adapt a TEE was confidential computing environment. Okay, at last, I'd like to introduce a future work of Graphene Library OS in the community. First one is container as a next step of GSC, container runtime support is very important. So that user can seamlessly run container with TE enabled. And also for production use, hardening of graphene library OS is addressed. And also, more language runtime support is planned, is being developed, for example, to support Java or Go language. Also, the graphene community applied for confidential computing consortium. And right now, we are under legal review. And hopefully, it will be accepted soon. Yeah, thank you for listening. After this video, I can take questions. Thank you so much.